Did you know that from one photo, you can tell the position of a drone and prove whether it was in restricted airspace? Or that from one photo, you can tell if a paparazzi photographer was trespassing on your land? All you need for this is a camera image, the relative 3D positions of a bunch of points on that image, and some math. I'm an Aaron Becker, and in this mini lecture, I'm going to tell you a few things about determining the position of a camera and some properties of the camera just from a single image. Whenever you take a picture with a camera, the light comes in through a little pinhole, or your lens, and it enters and it hits on the image plane in the back of your camera. So one thing that you need to know about your camera is the distance from the lens to that image plane. We'll call that the focal length. Now there's two coordinate frames we worry about. One coordinate frame is affixed to the camera. What we want to know in this problem is where is that camera compared to some coordinate frame in the real world? So I'm going to call that with these scripts W, that those are the world and these are the camera. We'd like to know the relative position of these. These are called the extrinsic parameters of the camera because they're external. What is the position and orientation of your camera? The camera has an optical axis, light streams down there, and it projects onto the back of the image. And what we get are some pixel coordinates, which we're going to call U and V here. What we'd like to know is what is the location of the camera? So what is this vector of the camera frame and the world frame? And then we have a projective transform that takes the XYZ positions of the real world and projects them onto the lambda, which is the focal length of your image plane, and then UV coordinates. So we can represent that with some matrix transformations, where what we really want to know is what is the rotation from the world frame into the camera frame, and then what is the distance that we move from the world frame into the camera frame. And so, you know, one other little bit of complication is that we don't actually get the UV coordinates. Instead, we get some row column coordinates. And these are offset because arrays usually start from 0, 0, and whereas the center of the camera is at some OCOR point. And so there's a little bit of a transformation between there. These parameters, what is a scaling factor to make each pixel, the SX and SY, and also what is the principal axis, the zero point in the UV space, this OR and OC, these are intrinsic properties of the camera. We need to learn those as well. So what we do is we take some image, and so here's an image taken from my apartment, and then you just need to measure the position of a bunch of points in that. So if you get over 20, my code that I'll provide you with today will work pretty good. But I just use a ruler and measure the X, Y, Z positions of these. And I determine those X, Y, Zs by just assigning a coordinate frame somewhere in the image. So I put my coordinate frame on the bottom left of this table, and then I measured everything relative to that position. Once you've got a big data set that has all these X, Y, Z positions, the next thing that we need to do is figure out the pixel location of them. After we do that, we'll do a whole bunch of math. We'll do some inversion, and it's really just a linear matrix inversion to solve for these unknown parameters. And at the end of this, the code is going to spit out, you know, what is your unknown parameters. For this to work, you're going to need three M files, the calibrate camera, find ortho center, and gather 3D data. And then you'll need your image in there. I've called mine cameracalp1.jpg. Just remember whatever that name is. So let's look at what 3D data is. In 3D data, this is one that you're going to have to edit yourself. And all you have to do is edit this data W section. And in here, you put the XYZ locations of the item that you care about, and also a text description of that. That'll make it easier to click on that. What I've done is I've used sets of four items at a time because it's really easy to click on square things. So once you've entered in all these points, you see I've got a number of them. You need at least 20 to make it work pretty well because there's a number of parameters that we're going to try to find. Then it's time to run the calibrate camera. If you're interested, here's a link here for the original article about this. It's also in the Spong, Vidigaskar, and Hutchinson textbook and many other places. We run this code, and the first thing it wants us to do is find the row column locations of a bunch of places in the image. And it gives you some text. This is the text that you guys wrote in when you were making the calibrate camera code. Now, if you don't know where this is, we can make this image smaller, and we can compare this to our other figure. And this figure here isn't just another image that shows you where the locations of things are. It's a 3D image, and it's just made from those XYZ locations that you measure yourself. But looking over here, it makes it easier to remember which one is paper one, or which one is a table that we talk about. So feel free to switch between these images, and it's easy to figure out where you are. Or if you're really cool and you have two screens, just put one on one screen. So now it's time to start clicking. I click on my bottom left image, bring this line over to the bottom right, going right to the tip of my mouse, And then the nice thing here is that you've got a little square that'll complete this out, make it easier for you to find those parts. Lots of clicking here. Just keep going until you've got all the points. You know, refer back to the other screen if you need help. And now I'm done. So I click on it. Now the next thing we have to do is we want to figure out where is the OR and the OC of our image. Now, most modern cameras, it's right in the center of the image, but maybe your camera isn't, and so it makes sense to calibrate that out. And so what we have to do first is find some parallel lines that are in our image. This table has a nice set of parallel lines that come all the way from here to here, and then I'll click on my second set from here to here. These parallel lines, as long as they're not perpendicular to my optical axis, they have a vanishing point. All I need is to find three sets of mutually perpendicular parallel lines, and those will form the corners of a triangle, and the orthocenter of that triangle is my optical center. Line set two, first line, second line, the back of my table makes a nice one. Then I need to find something that's perpendicular to those alls. Well, let's grab a vertical line of my house. There's one line. Let's grab this line over here. And so what you can see is over here, where these parallel lines meet are the vanishing point. And there are three different ones because they're all mutually orthogonal, and they form this black triangle. And the orthocenter, which is made by going from the point and finding the right angle with the opposite wall of your triangle, where those three lines intersect, that's my OROC of my image. And then the code automatically figures out rotation matrix via from the world frame into your camera frame. What is a vector from your world frame to the camera frame? Then it figures out the scaling factor for both SX and SY and figures out where your camera is. So let's take a look at that one first. This is where my camera actually is. And it says that in this workspace, my camera was actually pointed way up here. So let's rotate that and see if that looks reasonable. It says that I was taking my image from right over here. Camera was pointing down. That looks pretty close to my image. The other way that you can check is you can compare the XYZ locations projected onto your image frame using the calibration that you discovered with the points that you clicked on. So let's see how close we are here. If we did everything perfectly, then these blue lines would be right on top of the red lines. They're pretty close. It's not perfect. You can see my optical center here, notation of which way is positive X and positive Y here. You can say, you know, I did pretty well. I can figure out where my camera is. The more accurate you are with your measurements and with your clicking, the better that this will be. One caveat, of course, is this is assuming that you have a linear camera that has no lens distortion. If you are using a fisheye camera, this isn't going to work very well. MATLAB has a bunch of built-in routines. It'll be better for you. The benefit of this code is it shows a linear way in order to do everything. You can find this on MATLAB Central. And also, for this thing, all you needed was a single image. You had to measure the 3D coordinates these points, and then you had to be able to click on those points in your image. Everything else is done for you. Now, normally what we do in robotics, if we get to change the environment, then what we'd want to do is paste a bunch of 3D barcodes. So if you go online and look at any of Boston Dynamics videos or other robotics videos, you'll see that often they will print off some 2D barcodes and put those on the image, because those automatically let your camera find those locations of that and figure out its relative position to those points. Well, it's been a pleasure. I hope you enjoy this code. Take care.